Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's video we are going to start a new concept which is a part of a model 2, but it is a quite different concept which we have studied earlier. So basically we are going to see what is a DC motor, AC motor and how you can control the speed of a DC and AC motors. And to control the speed, what are the devices or what are the equipments are required that we are going to study in our upcoming videos. Now before we start with the electric drive element, first let me tell you what is a drive. So here we are studying the subject which is known as a industrial electronics. That means we are dealing with a different kind of industrial application, different kind of domestic application. For example, you must be aware of the industrial applications such as hydraulic pump, then machines. Hydraulic machines, gas turbines, then steam turbines. These are the different types of a washing machine. You can take the domestic application as a washing machine, mills. These are the different applications where we need to control the speed of the motor. So basically what is the controlling the speed is nothing but it is a motion controlling. And the device which used to control the motion is known as a drive. Remember what is drive is to control the motion of any appliance or any motor, you can say that device is called as a drive. Now if that drive is using some electronic equipments, then that particular drive can be called as a electronic drive, correct? You can be have a conventional drive or you can be have a electric drive. Conventional drive is a normal drive which you can say it is a manual drive where you have to take the actions manually. But if you go for an electric drive, the advantage of electric drive, you can handle some phenomena automatically. That is the advantage of electric drive over a conventional drive. Now this advantages we are going to see in the next upcoming video. But you should know that in a different kind of industrial and domestic applications I have listed before, we need to control the motion, we need to control the speed as per the requirement of application. And to control that particular speed, we need to have a drive. Your drive can be either electric or it can be a conventional drive. And basically the speed of the motor which is to be controlled, that motor can be either DC or AC. So in this particular chapter we are going to see what are the DC motors parameter that need to be controlled if you want to control the speed of a DC motor, and what are the parameters that need to be considered about the AC motor if you are controlling the speed of the AC motor. So this both the things we are going to study. Before that we'll study the basic elements of electric drive. So here we have a diagram of a basic element of electric drive. So the blocks are energy source. Now here somewhere you are providing a energy. So how you are going to control the speed, how you are going to control the motion is by controlling the power or by controlling the energy provided. Basically for any particular circuit or for any device, you need to have some supply. Either it can be a voltage supply or it can be a current supply. So that voltage supply is nothing but energy source over here. From where exactly you are going to provide the energy to that particular drive or that particular circuit. The next is a power modulator. Now what is the required of a power modulator? You need to modulate the power. We have studied this in the previous sections while studying the semiconductor devices. We have seen what is the need of a modulation. What exactly power you need to deliver to that particular load that should be controlled by some mechanism. Because as per the requirement of application, you know, need to provide the source energy or energy to the load. So that should be modulate, and that can be modulate either by the feedback or automatically without feedback. So basically you are going to have a closed loop control and open loop control. This is also the concept, one of the concept that we are going to use in AC and DC motor. Basically when it is an open control, when there is no feedback, that means you are not feeding back anything from the output side to the input side. That is an open loop, simple way. And closed loop is what? Some parameter you are feeding from output to the input side. That means you are making a one more feedback loop to that particular circuit, so that is known as a closed loop that we will study later. But here the power modulation can be done on the basis of a feedback to be provided to that particular module. Then next we have an electric motor, the actual motor which is going to drive your load. So basically motor and load will be connected and motor speed will going to drive the load which is connected to that particular motor. Then fourth is a load. Here you can see these are the listed parameters, sensing unit and control unit. Now let's see the block diagram. First of all, energy source, as I told you, you need to provide some kind of energy to run that particular complete mechanism. Then you have a power modulator. Power modulator is to modulate the energy which is to be given to the load. Now how you are going to modulate, on basis of what you are going to modulate, that will be, that can be sensed by using a sensing unit. So sensing unit is, you can see sensing unit is connected between motor and load, where motor is a device, or motor you can say is a drive which will drive your load. So basically the rotation, or you can say the mechanism of the load, can be controlled by using the motor. So what you can do to control the load mechanism or to control the operation of a load, you have to change the speed of the motor. Then ultimately motor will take some actions as per the requirement. So here some parameter, for example, if you are controlling the speed of a turbine, then speed can be fed back. So sensing unit can be a speed sensor. So that speed can be fed back to the control unit, and control unit, here you can give the input command. Your input command can be a set signal, you can say set speed or the reference speed. That means that that particular speed should be maintained so that my drive will work properly. So if there is a problem, that means if speed is more, you will get the negative feedback. If you see the reference speed and if you see the sense speed, then if sense speed is more than reference speed, you will get the negative error, correct? And if the speed, if the sense speed is less than the input speed or the set speed, then you will get the positive error. So basically what you are getting the error, and that error is nothing but your control signal. That control signal you are giving to the power modulator. Then according, if there is an error present, whether it is a positive or negative, depending on that it will modulate the speed of the motor. That means it can tell you whether you need to increase the speed of the motor or you need to decrease the speed of the motor, and that action can be take as compared to, or as based on, the control signal which you will get at the power modulator. So this is how the basic element or the basic diagram work for the electric drives. So we are going to see the different kind of configuration for this, like as I said, closed loop, open loop, then you have a DC, then you have a AC. In that also you have a few different types depending on the configuration. So how we actually sense the parameter, how we actually feedback those parameters and can control the speed of that either DC motor or AC motor, that we are going to see in the next upcoming video. Before that, I assume that you have understood what are the basic elements, what is exactly electric drive, what is the significance of this device in the application which we are going to study in the industrial electronics. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida. Do subscribe eKida. Thank you so much.